Hello and welcome. You're watching Today in Parliament with me, Ashwarya Kapoor, and here are the Parliament headlines. Rajya Sabha to discuss the working of Ayush Ministry. SPMP Ram Gopal Yadav to initiate discussion. Ayush Minister Shripad Yesso Naik to reply. Lok Sabha to take up discussion and voting on demands for grants for Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. Key bills are scheduled for introduction in Lok Sabha. NIA Amendment Bill 2019 listed for passing. And the Arbitration and Conciliation Amendment Bill 2019 listed for introduction in the Upper House. The bill seeks to amend the Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996. The Arbitration and Conciliation Amendment Bill 2019 is listed for introduction today. But first, news from Lok Sabha, where the discussion and voting on demands for grants for the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways for 2019-20 will be taken up. Demand for grants is an annual expenditure plan of each ministry for the financial year. It includes provisions with respect to revenue expenditure, capital expenditure, grants to the state governments, as well as loans and advances. And in the legislative business slated for the day today, the Motor Vehicles Amendment Bill 2019 will be introduced in the House today. The bill seeks to amend the Motor Vehicles Act 1988, and it aims to increase penalties on traffic violations, address issues on third-party insurance, the regulation of cab aggregators, road safety, opening the public transport sector for private players, and also regulate permits. And the Surrogacy Regulation Bill 2019, which aims to prohibit commercial surrogacy in India, is also listed for introduction in the lower house today. This bill proposes to regulate surrogacy in India by establishing a national surrogacy board at the central level and also state surrogacy boards. The bill was passed by the last Lok Sabha, but it lapsed after the dissolution of the House. And the National Investigation Agency Amendment Bill 2019 is also listed in the House for consideration and passing. This bill amends the National Investigation Agency Act 2008. The Act provides for a national-level agency to investigate and prosecute offences listed in the schedule. And the legislation will also allow the NIA probe cyber crimes and also cases of human trafficking. Further, the Act allows for the creation of special courts for the trial of the scheduled offences. Kriti Mishra is now joining us live from Parliament. Kriti, so talking first about Lok Sabha, of course, very important discussion and voting on demands for grants for the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways for 2019-20. And there are other key bills also listed, like the Motor Vehicles Bill, that are going to be introduced in the lower house today.
That's right, Aishwarya. On last Friday, remember, the Lok Sabha sat till 11:58 p.m. to discuss the demands for grants for the Ministry of Railways. And today also there are demands for grants and voting on the demands of Ministry of Road and Transport. Remember, these are the estimates of expenditure from Consolidated Fund of India and presented in the annual statement and have to be voted by the lower house. There are other important bills like the NIA Amendment Bill. This bill has already been introduced in the lower house, and when this bill was introduced by MOS Home Affairs Kishanji Reddy, he said that this bill will empower the NIA to also check cases of cyber crime as well as human trafficking. So this bill will fortify the NIA to protect the interests of India, both on soil, both on domestic as well as international soil. There's also important bill, which is the Motor Vehicles Amendment Bill, to impose stricter penalties in case of violations, would also be introduced in the lower house, as well as surrogacy regulation bill to actually regulate commercial surrogacy by establishing boards both at the national as well as the state level. So important agenda in the lower house today. Aishwarya?
Right. Kriti, stay with us. We'll just come back to you. And in the Rajya Sabha today, Union Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad will introduce the Arbitration and Conciliation Amendment Bill 2019. Which seeks to amend the Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996. It also aims to establish an independent body called the Arbitration Council of India for the promotion of arbitration, mediation, conciliation, and other alternative dispute redressal mechanisms. It provides for a time-bound settlement of disputes and the accountability of the arbitrator. A previous bill was cleared by Lok Sabha in August 2018, but it could not be passed by Rajya Sabha. The bill lapsed due to the dissolution of the 16th Lok Sabha. And also a discussion on the working of the Ayush Ministry is listed in today's agenda. SPMP Ram Gopal Yadav will initiate the discussion and Ayush Minister Shripad Yesso Naik will reply at the end of the discussion. All right, let's go back to Kriti Mishra, who's joining us live from Parliament. Kriti, as far as Rajya Sabha is concerned, of course, a very important bill, that of the Arbitration and Conciliation Bill, you know, is going to be introduced in the upper house. And this is a very important bill considering the fact that, you know, the arbitration and conciliation matters are of key importance to our country. And also a discussion on the working of Ayush Ministry listed in today's agenda.
That's right, Aishwarya. Remember, due to liberalization, privatization, globalization and industrialization, we've seen rise in the arbitration cases and also commercial disputes. So the countries like Singapore, UK and France have emerged as centres of arbitration. So with this bill, the government is trying to make India a hub of international as well as domestic arbitration. So this bill seeks to actually establish the Arbitration Council of India, which will be the autonomous body and will also provide for time-bound arbitration and also will fix the accountability of the arbitrator. There's another important discussion in the upper house, which is the discussion on the working of Ministry of Ayush. Remember, in the BAC meeting, it was decided that working of four ministries, which is the Ayush Ministry, MSME, External Affairs and Home Ministers, would be discussed in the upper house and 4 hours would be allotted for them. And today there would be discussion on Ayush Ministry that would be initiated by Professor Ram Gopal Yadav, SP, MP, wherein the members will discuss the working of the ministry. Remember, the government had actually organized, or rather formed, the new ministry, which is the Ayush Ministry, in the year 2014 to promote alternate medicine, which is homeopathy, Unani and Ayurveda. And also in budget 2019, we saw the allocation rise up to 2,000 crore rupees for the Ayush Ministry. So important discussion in the upper house today. Aishwarya?
All right, Kriti, thank you for all those updates there from Parliament. And with that, we wrap up this edition of Today in Parliament. Do stay tuned. The proceedings of the upper house are going to begin in a short while from now at 11 a.m. Thanks for watching.
On how many occasions motion of thanks was amended in Rajya Sabha? The motion of thanks on the President's address in Rajya Sabha has been amended